What's going on, guys? John Elderhood from Codemy.com, and in this video, we're going to look at copy versus view for NumPy. All right, guys, like I said, in this video, we're going to look at copy versus view for NumPy. But before we get started, if you like this video and want to see more like it, be sure to smash the like button below, subscribe to the channel, give me a thumbs up for the YouTube algorithm, and check out Codemy.com, where I have dozens of courses with thousands of videos that teach you to code. Use coupon code YouTube50 to get 50% off membership. It's all my courses, videos, and books for one-time fee, which is insanely cheap. Okay, like I said, in this video, we're going to look at copy versus view for NumPy. So right off the bat, a copy is a copy of your array. You just make a copy of it. A view is also a copy of an array, but it's still connected to the original array. And I'll show you what I mean by that in just a second. So let's head over to our code. I'm using the Sublime Text Editor and the Git Bash Terminal as always. And as always, you can find a link to the code in the pinned comment section below, as well as a link to the playlist with all the other NumPy videos in this series. So check that out if you haven't so far. So I've got our basic starter code. We've just imported NumPy as MP. I'm calling this copyView.py. And let's just create a quick NumPy array. And I'm just gonna call this MP1. And we're gonna set that to a NumPy array. And then I don't know, we'll just make something up real quick. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, whatever. So, okay, we've got this. Now let's create a view. So I'm gonna create a new NumPy array. I'm gonna call it MP2. And this is just gonna be MP1.view, right? So we've now got these two arrays and they're the same thing. So let's come down here and let's print some stuff. Let's create an F string and let's say original MP1. And this is going to be MP1. And let me just kind of copy this. And let's say original MP2. And we'll print that out. So that'll just print out our two arrays here. So now let's take an element in MP1 and change it. So let's go MP1 and let's say the zeroth item. So that will be this zero, right? Let's go ahead and change that to 41, right? So now I'm going to take these two things here and I'm going to print them again. And here, let's say, now this is the changed MP1, right? And then let's have the original MP2. We haven't changed it at all. We're just gonna print it out again. So let's go ahead and save this, head over to our terminal. I'm in my C num directory, and let's go Python copyView.py. And so, okay, we have the original MP1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We've got the original MP2, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then we changed the first element of MP1 to 41, and we see that here, 41, 2, 3, 4, 5. But here's the original MP2. Remember, we didn't change it at all, and it also has the 41. And that's because whenever we change the original, the view gets changed too. So it's a copy, but it's still connected to the original, right? And that's the difference between copying and viewing. So if there are times when you just want to take a snapshot of the original and you still want to be connected to it. So if you do make changes to the original, it gets reflected in your copy. You're going to use this dot view function, right? So likewise, we can create a copy and I'm just going to, let's just comment out all of this stuff here and start over. We've got still our original array, but now let's create a copy of that. So let's go MP2 and this is going to be MP1.copy. Remember up here, we did dot view to make a view. We do dot copy to make a copy. So now I'm going to grab all of this stuff and let's just go ahead and print this again. So we've got our original MP1, we've got our original MP2. Those should still be the same. This thing right here, right? Now we're gonna take MP1 and add 40 and change the first element to 41. Then we're going to print them out and see what has changed and what stayed the same. So let's head back over here. Run this guy again. And now we've got our original and our copy, right? And then we changed the original to 41 right here. But now you'll see the copy did not update. And up here, when we updated the original, the copy, the view updated to 41, here it did not, right? So really kind of interesting. And that's all there is to it. Now let's also play around with this and let's play with the, let's say, instead of changing MP1, let's change MP2, right? So the copy, right? So let's go ahead and save this. Let's clear the screen, run this guy again. So now we've got the original and the original copy. We changed the copy, but the original did not change because again, the copy is a completely different array. It's a completely separate thing. It's not connected to the original. If we come back here, in fact, let's just comment out all of this stuff here. And let's uncomment out our original stuff right here. And let's do the same thing. Instead of changing MP1, let's change MP2. So we're changing the copy, the view, right? And you'll notice this is actually kind of interesting. If we clear this screen and run this again, here we've got the original and the copy. We changed the copy, the view, and the original gets changed. So that's really weird, right? So you've got this, come back over here and look, you've got this original array. We made a view, we changed the view, and then the original changed. So very weird. So they're both connected both ways. If you make a change to the original one, the view will update. If you make a change to the view, the original will update. So they're connected in both ways. And then down here with a copy, like we showed, they're not connected in any way, right? It's just a flat out copy. So all kinds of different reasons why you might want to use a view versus a copy. We'll get into some of those reasons in the future when we play around with NumPy and more interesting circumstances and start actually using this stuff for machine learning stuff. But just keep in mind, copy and view. Copy is completely separate from the original. View is always connected both ways. Just sort of keep that in mind, and that's all there is to it. So that's all for this video. If you liked it, be sure to smash the like button below, subscribe to the channel, give me a thumbs up for the YouTube algorithm, and check out Codemy.com where you can use coupon code YouTube50 to get 50% off membership. So it's access to all my courses, over 50 courses, thousands of videos, and the PDFs of all my best-selling coding books. Join over 150,000 students learning to code just like you. My name is John Elder from Codemy.com, and I'll see you in the next video.